Good afternoon, everybody. First of all, I would like to say that I would like to thank Keith Parsons very much for giving me this opportunity to talk to such a large wireless gathering. It's really fantastic to be here and to be exchanging, interacting with peers which are also real Wi-Fi enthusiasts. My talk is going to be about the 2.4 gigahertz frequency. It's also be sometimes it's be called the junk band, but I run a large WLAN for Avans University in the Netherlands. At peak times, we have 12,000 devices together online in the spectrum. And then we're pushing about 1.2 gigabits towards and from the internet. So with that kind of amount of devices and with that kind of amount of data, you really need lots of spectrum. And that's why I also consider the 2.4 gigahertz frequency not to be obsolete, but I need all the spectrum I can have. This is an example of a busy day at Avans University in our learning center, which again states my point. We need in the university, in a high density environment, you need all the spectrum you can get. One side note, you may notice that I'm using a four channel plan, which is considered a bit challenging by the US delegates. But, well, we can talk about this in the bar later on in the evening, I guess. But it's about interference. And this slide shows strange interference. One day I was visiting a building on our campus in Sertogenbosch. And while doing a run through the building with my Wi-Spy analyzer, I was catching up this strange reading. And, well, this is not normal interference behavior, because you get the occasional motion detection, you get a really spiked signal of interference in the 2.4 gigahertz. And this is continuous, and it's not pulsating, but it appears to me as a sort of ripples in. It appears to me sort of as ripples in the water. That's what how it occurred to me. And then when you read lots of blog posts on the internet about Wi-Fi, as I do, I want to take you to the theory. And this is the blog post which, when I was thinking about the type of interference, which caught my attention. This is a blog post on the site of 7signal. And this blog post describes that cellular base tower stations, which are placed on top of buildings, and this building of ours had a base tower station placed on top of the building, that the cellular frequencies coming off from the base tower station, they can generate a sort of let's see it interference, because the you get distortion coming off the cellular signal, which lands in the receiver of a WLAN antenna. And there is the talk of G.T. Hill before me was also about this this phenomenon, that the signals, when they meet each other, they don't interfere. You get interference when you get strange signals landing in your antenna. And that was what caught my attention. And then I had to, this is the theory, and then I had to prove that it was the case. So I did the following. I brought in the tools. On the left hand of the slide, you see a Wi-Spy channel, Wi-Spy MetaGeek Wi-Spy interference detector, but you also see a so-called bandpass filter. And a bandpass filter is a filter which basically narrows down on the 2.4 gigahertz, and it excludes all the other interfering signals. And that's in the middle. You see me sitting behind my laptop with a patch panel antenna pointing towards the base tower station, which is located on the top of the roof. So what I did was I had a planar antenna so that you can more or less see it as a searchlight, so you get a real reading of where the interference is coming from. And then if you apply the band filter in the same manner, and then you get a reading with and without the band filter applied. And my thought was that if I did the spectrum analysis with and without the band filter applied, then it would prove the theory that the interference was coming from the base tower station. So that is the next slide. You see here, I'll walk over to this screen. In the middle, you see the just the normal Wi-Fi behavior. And at the bottom line, you see the interference coming. So in the middle, that's the place where I applied the bandpass filter, pointing at the planar antenna pointing towards the base tower station. So this pretty much proved, with using the tools, proved my theory that the interference was coming from the base tower station. Next question, is it bad? Does it affect my performance of my VLAN? I don't think so currently, because I did not have any complaints, and the Wi-Fi was still operating, and I did some search in the theory. There is an excellent white paper from Marcus Burton on this kind of theory, in which he mentions the amount of energy which is needed to distort the Wi-Fi communications. So I don't think that applies to this situation. But you will see in the next coming years, you will see a merger of cellular technology and Wi-Fi being used indoor and outdoor. So this is one of the things you might take into account while doing site surveys or making designs for networks in which these technologies collide. This is my punchline. We are in Texas, and excuse my pronunciation, but my motto would be for this conference, keep fixing to it, and thank you all.